Welcome guys, welcome to my channel Marine Sea Time. Today I will be discussing about different types of valves in ships and its uses. So in ships we have many valves such as globe valve, gate valve, butterfly valve, check valve, relief valve, safety valve. So I will be discussing about all that, and I will be generally I will focus on where this all types of valve will be used on ships with the line diagram. So first we will discuss about the globe valve. So there are basically two types of globe valve. One is return type globe valve and the other one is non-return type globe valve. So in the diagram you can see this is the return type of globe valve, and return type of globe valve is like straight through and angle globe valve. So there are two types of return type globe valve. One is straight through and angle globe valve. In this figure you can see this is the straight flow return type globe valve. So you can see here how it looks like. So in the globe valve it has a bulbous body, and it has a seat. You can see this is the seat. This is the seat over here. This is the valve disc. This is the spindle. This is the packing. So and the flow is from below the flow is from the below the valve seat, so that the gland is not subjected to higher static pressure when the valve is closed. This is all about the return type globe valve. So the return type of globe valve is mainly used in lube oil and fuel oil filling, transfer and purifying system. So this type of return type, this is the most common type. About if there is 100% valve in the ship, then approx of 60 to 70% of the valve used in ship is this type of globe valve. This is basically used in all lube oil and fuel oil filling. Suppose we have a bunker tank, so the suction and the suction of the fuel oil bunker tank, the suction side of the fuel oil transfer pump, suction side of purifier supply pump, filling and suction valve of HFO bunker tank. Now number 2, its uses is in boiler feed water system. Number 3 uses is in control air system. Number 4 in steam service system. In steam service system there is no non-return valve here. Number 5th is compressed air service system. So let's discuss the symbol of the globe valve. So you can see the first one is a globe valve. How it what is the symbol of this globe valve? Angle valve, gate valve, screw down non-return valve, screw down non-return valve, angle type, non-return valve globe, non-return valve angle, and swing check valve. This is the symbol of the globe valve. Now second is the non-return type globe valve. This is out of 100% the non-return type globe valve is used is approx 20%. So 60% is we use return type, we use globe valve return type, and 20% we use non-return type globe valve. So non-return type globe valve is also has also two parts, straight through and angle non-return valve. So you can see in the figure, this is a basic example of a non-return valve. You can see there is no valve spindle, no handle. So this is automatic type of non-return valve. Automatically it will close. So first I will discussing about straight through and angle non-return valve. So this the uses of it is very less. Straight through an angle non-return valve, the usage is very less. So its uses are very less. Example, before the three-way valve of the purifier inlet. So it is used in before the three-way valve of the purifier inlet, we use this return type straight through non-return globe valve. This automatically closes as the flow. So in this type you can see the flow will be from here, and it will, so there will be no flow from here. So the liquid will flow in only one direction, it will not flow in the other direction. So this is the non-return valve. Now the second type of non-return valve is screw down non-return valve. This is the most common which we use in all ships. So you can see over here, this is the valve disc, this is the spindle, this is the valve seat. The valve seat and the valve disc faces are steel light and almost indestructible. The spindle or stem may have a V or square thread or above the stuffing box. If the latter, it will work in a removable or an integral bridge. So this spindle will attach with the disc with a nut. So if this is attached with the disc, then this is the return type of valve. And if this spindle is not attached with the disc, then it is a non-return type of valve. Now you can see this is the gland, this is the yoke bush, this is the yoke bush, this is the gland. You can see over here, this is the gland, and you can see this is the bonnet nut. Now this is the bonnet, this is the valve, this is the valve body, this is the valve body. The flow is from here, from below the valve seat, and the outlet is from here. So you can see all the parts of the screw down non-return valve. So this is generally used in ships. This is the, so uses discharge side of HFO transfer pump and purifier supply pump. So it is used in the discharge side of any pump, so that the flow will not return back. Boiler feed water check valve. So we have the boiler feed water check valve. So we have two check valve in boiler feed water. One is of non-return type, another one is totally closed type. So it is used in boiler feed water check valve, fire and bilge pump discharge valve. suction valve of bilge valve, suction and discharge valve of bilge transfer pump and bilge separator pump. So in the bilge system, it is used on both suction and discharge valve of both the of the pump. Emergency bilge suction, discharge of air compressor and air bottle. So the air compressor discharge of air, we will have this type of valve, screw down and valve, and air bottle. Steam condensate system. In all the tank drain, we have a steam condensate system. In that, we have a screw down and valve. Freshwater service system, main engine lube oil pump discharge valve. So these are all the uses of screw down and valve. Now we'll be talking about butterfly valve. The second type of valve is butterfly valve. There are various type of butterfly valve. They are wafer lever type, lug lever type. So you can see this is the butterfly valve. You can see this is the lever type of valve. This is the lever type of. Press this lever. Press this, and then rotate. Then rotate the lever. So the valve disc will move in its valve body. So we have a gland over here. You can see this is the gland. This is the valve disc. This is the spindle. And by turning this lever, we can rotate the valve disc. So this is the lever type. Lever type, we have wafer type and lug type. Another third one, another second, third number C is wafer gearbox type and lug gearbox type. So this is the gearbox type. This, here you can see it has a handle over here. This is the handle. Rotate this handle. We have a gear arrangement over here. So by rotating it, the gear will engage and it will rotate the valve disc. So first one was lever type and second one was gear type. So this is the gear type. So one by one we will be discussing where all we use this lever and gear type of butterfly valve. In all seawater pipeline valve. So in all seawater pipeline valve, we use butterfly valve. Cooling seawater pump, suction and discharge valve, suction valve for fire and bilge pump from bilges and cargo hold bilges. In low temperature cooling water system, LT water inlet and outlet to air cooler, lube oil cooler, etc. So LT water inlet to the air cooler and also LT water inlet and outlet of the lube oil cooler, we use butterfly type of valve. In HT cooling system, in HT cooler, both inlet and outlet valve for LT and jacket water. No butterfly used in fuel oil and lube oil system. So butterfly valve is generally not used in fuel oil and lube oil system. The butterfly valve used in that system only where the quantity of the fluid is more. So freshwater generator, suction and discharge valve. So the freshwater generator, HT water inlet and outlet of the freshwater generator is basically of a butterfly valve. The last butterfly valve is the check valve, butterfly check valve, which is very important. Butterfly check valve are basically non-return valve. The butterfly check valve are basically non-return type. So you can see this is the butterfly check valve. So there is no spindle, there is no hand wheel or anything. You can see as the water goes from here, the disc will be pushed, and the disc will, as the disc is pushed, it will come like this. And the water will flow, and there will be no flowing back of water, because as the water flows back, the disc will close the valve. So this is how this butterfly check valve works like. So this butterfly check valve is used in cooling seawater pump discharge, same as freshwater generator ejector pump discharge. So this is all about the butterfly valve. Now I will talk about the gate valve. So this is the gate valve. So you can see this is the gate valve. So gate valve is used for on and off control. Either you close that valve or you open that valve. So now, gate valve offers little resistance in fully open condition, allow full flow of fluid. So it will not resist any flow of liquid. It is very cheaper. It is unidirectional flow. It is a unidirectional flow valve. But the difference between this gate valve and globe valve is that globe valve can be used for flow regulation. By globe valve, we can regulate the flow. Globe valve offer little resistance to flow in full open condition. So globe valve offers some resistance to the flow of fluid. And globe valve also bidirectional, but gate valve is unidirectional and it is only used for on and off control. Either there will be flow or there will be no flow. So it is unidirectional, that is, it always flows only in one direction. So you can see this is the gate valve over here. So you can see the spindle is attached with the. So we have two types of gate valve. One is rising stem type and the other one is non-rising stem type. So in this figure you can see this is the non-rising type of stem. Non-rising stem type of gate valve. When the spindle is connected with the valve disc through threads, you can see the thread is here. And now the valve disc is also known as gate. The valve disc is also known as gate is moved at a right angle. So the valve disc will move at a right angle into the flow. So if the flow is this, then the valve disc will move upward. So as the hand wheel is rotated, the spindle will rotate, and it will make the valve disc to move up and down. So this gate valve cannot be used as in a throttled position or in a partially open operation, since wire drawing of the seat can occur. So the bonnet of these valves are frequently of cast iron, and care should be taken when overhauling. Both the gate and the valve seat. So you can see the gate and the valve seat. This is the valve seat over here. Valve seat. The gate and the valve seat have a taper. Either the gate and the valves can be the valves and seat may be tapered or parallel, on their facing side. And also the gate and valve seat have taper, and when tightened they will seal against each other. This is how the valve disc or gate is tapered with the valve seat. So these two are always so these two, when closed, they fully tighten each other and seal each other, so that there should be no leakage from suction to the discharge side. So the gate valve used is very less, approximately 0.0001% in ships. The gate valve which I have seen in ship is only a few places, like during the boiler tube washing, the drain of that water washing is usually of gate valve, either fully open that valve or fully close that valve. This is the two function of this gate valve. Either you open it or you close it. You cannot regulate the flow through the gate valve. So the number fourth is the safety valve. So this is the safety valve. You can see over here. This is the safety valve. This is the valve lid. This is the valve lid. This is the valve seat. This is the valve. This is the valve seat. This is the lip clearance. You can see this is the spindle. This is the spindle. This is the spindle. We have a exhaust steam piston spring over here. Now, this is the floating ring. So steam pressure acts on the valve lid and it will compress the spring, and the steam will go out from here. And the compressed and the exhaust steam piston will help in moving the spring up, and will allow the steam pressure to release from the safety valve. So safety valve is generally used in where there is a high pressure, like in boiler. So one by one we will discuss. So there are basically three types of globe or straight through type safety valve: ordinary safety valve, high lift safety valve, and improved high lift safety valve. So it uses in every plate type heat exchanger of lube oil and fuel oil. Number 2 is in air bottle. Number 3 is in boiler. Number 4 is in every gear after the fuel oil supply pump, in fuel oil service system of main engine, etc. So in the fuel oil line diagram, after the fuel oil supply pump, we have a safety valve. Suppose the line pressure suddenly increases, so this will release all the fuel oil into the engine, all the fuel oil from the fuel. So this is where the safety valve is used. Where there is a high pressure, it can develop, we will use the safety valve. Relief valve is this, like this is the relief valve. You can see valve body, disc, stuffing box, gland, stem, spring, adjusting nut. By adjusting nut, we can adjust the opening pressure of the relief valve. So safety valve, really, if the safety valve lifts, it will release all the pressure. But relief valve lifts when the pressure in the system rises above 10%, and safety valve lifts when the pressure rises above 3%. So the relief valve can be straight through an angle type. So use of this relief valve is scavenger receiver. So scavenger receiver, we have a relief valve. In all the gear pump, like mostly fuel oil supply pump is of gear pump, fuel oil circulating pump is of gear pump, fuel oil transfer pump is of gear pump. So in all this, we have a relief valve which releases the suction side. If the pressure increases, then it will release the oil to the discharge side after every stage of air compressor in the cylinder cover of main engine, in the discharge side of refrigerant compressor. So in the discharge side of refrigerant compressor, we have a relief valve, and also fitted in the condenser, and also it is fitted in the refrigerant condenser. And the last one is the keep closing valve. So this is how the keep closing valve looks like. You have a valve spindle. This is same like as a butterfly valve. This is the valve spindle. This is the disc. This is the gland. Now this is the lower bearing. This is the upper bearing over here. So this butterfly valve can be actuated by electric, pneumatic. So we have an actuator over here. You can see we have actuator over here. So as it is pushed here, the valve disc will move from this position to this position, or from this position to this position. So during a fire, the valve disc will close and it will shut the fuel oil supply to the engine. So this is the basic operation of a keep closing valve. It is very quick. The valve is very quick. It acts very quick, and only a quarter turn of the spindle is required to move the valve from fully open to fully closed position. So we'll see where is the key closing valve used. So you can see this in all the section of the HFO service and settling tank to purifier, section of bunker tank to settling tank, section of waste oil service tank to incinerator, section of generator engine lube oil settling and service tank, section of main engine lube oil settling and lube oil service tank, section of cylinder oil storage tank. So here we have this key closing valve. Key closing valve is actuated from away from the engine room, from the remote places. We can also actuate the key closing valve. So during a fire, the keep closing valve actuates and it will close the HFO tank or any tank to go into the system. So the various valve symbols are, you can see this is the symbols of globe valve, this is the symbol of angle valve, jet valve, screw down non-return valve, angle, screw down non-return valve, angle type, non-return valve globe, non-return valve angle, swing check valve. So this is the three-way valve, pressure reducing valve, safety valve angle, self-closing straight through, self-closing angle valve, regulating valve, kick closing valve, kick closing valve, butterfly valve, butterfly valve, wafer type, gearbox type, butterfly valve, flange lever type, butterfly valve, flange gearbox type, butterfly valve, lug lever type, butterfly valve, lug gearbox type, butterfly check valve, wafer type, butterfly check valve, flange type, butterfly check valve, lug type, ball valve, foot valve, needle valve, relief valve, relief valve angle. So guys, this is all about the various valves and its uses on ship. So I basically focused on where all we use this valve and ship. Hope you all guys like the video. If you liked it, please like and share. And if you haven't subscribed till now, please subscribe to the channel to get more videos like this. Thank you. God bless you all.